Mimi sent this video. I ain't mean to put Mimi out like that, but Mimi sent me this video of AliexsSky yelling at her daughter. First thing I'm gonna say, I don't like how this person, I think that's why he turned his comments off. He or she. I think it's a she. She turned her comments off because this is what she titled the video. AliexsSky yells at her disabled daughter on Instagram Live 02-02-21. Like, we all know the girl, you know, is whatever. Why you had to put disabled daughter? She could have just put daughter. We still would have watched it. I ain't like that. That's first off. But let's go ahead and start this video. It's 5 minutes long. I might cut this. Oh.
So I'm getting these oars out to y'all. Yes. You need to open? Okay, but I need you to get the right size for me. So if that's not the right size, so you need to 1 second. Go ahead, play with your toys.
But yeah, I just honestly came on live, sir.
I can't focus on like one thing at a time. Just want to let you guys know that the orders will be out tomorrow. I want an extra large, how I go about it. So I'm restocking in 2 weeks. I only have tan left.
Can you wear a faja when you're pregnant? I'm reading the comments. Can you wear a faja when you're pregnant? No. Why would you want to wear a girdle when you're pregnant? That's dumb. Somebody said, how you ask her to twerk while her baby there? Oh, this nigga's in the comments talking about twerk. Her baby's right there. For real. That's one thing I ain't never see, like, Alex. I don't know, but I ain't never see her do no, like, crazy shit in front of her baby. That's not crazy, but, you know, whatever. Nice, your face. I think somebody tried to say your face is nice. She is pretty.
Okay. What?
It's hot, baby. Hot.
Mommy's about to get your soup first. The soup is hot, baby. Hot.
No, do not touch that stove.
Mommy's making you soup. No, do not touch that stove.
Alea, don't play with me.
Don't you ever.
What I just said.
Alea, don't play with me. Don't.
Mommy's
what I just said.
It's really hot, Alea.
Don't play with me. Mommy's gonna get you soup. It's really hot, Alea. Soup. I'm trying.
Let's pause the video. Not the dope dealer charger just passed by. There's a lot of dope dealers right here. All right, let's keep going. Copyright. Someone said, what you doing? I ain't gonna lie, I'm trying to figure out why she putting the chicken noodle soup in a cup.
Let it cool down.
I guess because she's busy, she can't really sit and feed her. Or is it just because it's really just soup and ain't no noodles in it? I don't know. Somebody said, put a block of ice in it to cool it down. Somebody said, why she can't eat a regular, if you don't mind me asking.
Yeah.
I think it's just because she's busy. Somebody said, soup
okay,
in a cup.
Well, I'm Jamaican.
That's for my ass on.
You put soup inside. You drain the chicken noodle soup.
Yeah.
And you put it in a bottle.
Y'all never heard. Okay, well.
Somebody said, she's straight out the hood.
You put soup inside. You
She said, because she Trinidad. That's why she doing it. Like she Trinidadian. I ain't gonna lie. If it's Trinidad and Tobago, why they only say Trinidadian? Whatever. Stop criticizing her, y'all. Damn. I'm Jamaican. That's the first I'm hearing of that. Okay, she. Somebody else said facts and they put a Jamaican flag. So. She put cool water in it to calm it down, to cool it down. Oh, she did put ice in. I hear the ice. She yelled at her because she told her not to touch the stove. That was dumb. That was a dumb video. That's why she turned the comments off. That was a stupid video. But the next video I'm gonna watch is this one. It says Jada apologized to customer after this, and AliexsSky closes shop after employee. Okay, so Jada, I think there's one girl, she, I don't know what Jada had to apologize for. I guess I don't know if that's what they're gonna talk about, but it was this one girl, she received the outfit from Jada and she didn't really like it. She was like, I could see the patchwork, I could see through the pockets and stuff like that. That's, I don't know if that's why Jada had to apologize though. I don't know. And then the other one, AliexsSky, this girl was working there, I guess, answering phones, and then the girl had quit, and AliexsSky had didn't put the money in the account in time, so she came back for her check, but she didn't put the money in the account in time, so the lady would like come back tomorrow. So she came back the next day, and I guess the lady wrote her a check and she put it in her account, and then like I think 5 days later the whole account went negative because the check bounced. So let's see if that's what they're gonna be talking about in this video. It's room for tea.
Hey my lovely TTs, welcome back to the channel. Let's get straight into the tea. So am I
yesterday? Yeah, it is the girl with the outfit I was talking about.
Check that out before you check out this video so you can be all caught up. But I was letting you guys know that one of Jada's customers had bought an outfit off of her website and decided to do a review on TikTok. Now, in this review, she wasn't so satisfied with what she had bought because the pants were a little shorter than what she expected, and it seemed like, you know, everything was just thin. It was thin. It wasn't high quality.
I ain't gonna lie. I didn't like it either. When I looked at it, I like, that looked like something. That don't even look like something you buy at a boutique. Like, it was like really, I ain't gonna lie, it was really cheaply made. And I don't know how much she's selling her outfit for. But I don't, if it wasn't for $5, it wasn't worth the money. I ain't gonna lie to you.
So she made this TikTok, she put it out there, and it blew up. It went crazy, it went all over the blog pages. You know, everybody was talking about it, and eventually it went to the shade room. And like I said, I knew once it went to the shade room that Jada was going to respond. And of course, like right after, only a couple of minutes after it was posted onto the shade room, that's when Jada decided to respond on her Insta story. Now, Jada wasn't so happy about this. And it kind of seems like she, you know, her response was pointed towards the customer. Well, it looks like that wasn't exactly the case. We'll get into it later, but let's see what the customer decided to
do.
Now, there was a lot of people who were saying, and even Jada said it in her own Insta story, that she felt like this customer could have just emailed her customer service. Like I said yesterday, I was like, that could have been one of the options. She could have did that. But it seems like she had already did that before she made the TikTok.
So supposedly she wrote the people, the customer service people, and they didn't respond. And obviously Jada didn't see it because she said, you could have just wrote me on there. So I don't know. What does this say? So I don't know. Well, let's keep going.
So the email said, my name is blah, blah, blah. And I ordered.
Oh, she posted the email.
Pants and cream jacket, order number, and she put her order number out there. She said, I am highly disappointed. The pants are
clean. So obviously nobody's seen the customer service
and my underwear show very easily. The pants are also way too short and they look like high waters on me, and I'm only 5'1". The pants are also too tight on the, you know what, area. make me look like my butt is super flat. The heart of the jacket has iron patches on it, shaped like a square that will not come out. I'm very upset and have been a fan of Jada for forever. I am disappointed with the quality of the items I received.
But the part is, Jada been doing this for a very long time. What was Jada selling? She was selling stuff already. What was she selling? I forgot what her daddy had. Her daddy, like, she started a, she been selling stuff, so I don't know.
The amount of money, excuse me, that I paid for these items, and that's what I said. And she said, I also was not aware that there was a no return policy. And the rest was cropped out because she decided to put, here's the email that I never sent yesterday. Now, you know, after Jada even posted her response to all of this, a lot of, you know, people were upset.
Oh, wow, she didn't even give it time. She said, this the email I never sent yesterday. You gotta wait at least 3 days, to tell you the truth, for customer service to hit you back. I don't know.
This young lady was not disrespectful to you. You have no reason to be posting.
Sam here is anxious. He's
ooh, commercial.
For that new credit card, so he's procrastinating. Like, really procrastinating.
On your Insta story, going against her because she was not rude. She was giving her honest opinion on the set that she bought with her hard earned money, and she paid a lot of money for it. So Jada decided to clear up things today and let everybody know that she wasn't directing her Insta story post or her response towards this young lady. She was directing her response towards the blog pages that decided to post it. And this is what Jada posted. She said, my post was to the blogs tearing down businesses. No blog posted nothing about my release or me selling out in 30 minutes, but can't wait to post a customer unsatisfied. We took care of the customer who wasn't pleased, as we do every customer. I'm sorry about this and taking everything into consideration. So she lets it be known there. Look, I'm not talking to this young lady. I'm actually talking to the blog page. Now, I'm definitely glad that Jada did clear that up, because at first, everyone thought that Jada was responding to young lady, and I'm not gonna lie, it does seem like she was talking to her, but she cleared it up and she let it be known that she was talking to the blog.
I feel like she was talking to her. She was talking to every fucking body that had something to say. That's how I feel. Like, I feel like she was talking to everybody.
Blog pages. Now, I do think that she was talking to the blog and the young lady at the same time at the moment, but I think she thought about it and then seen all the comments and she was like, no, that's not right. Giving her review on the items. Now, ever since this situation and this TikTok was posted, Jada has been posting a lot of great reviews of people who are actually pleased with what they have ordered onto her Insta story. And like she said she gets more positive feedback than negative. So that.
But why this girl outfit look better than the other? You know what?
I'll definitely let me know.
Yeah, why they outfit look? I don't know. Maybe it's not the same outfit.
Let's go ahead and move into our next topic. Now, it looks like Jada Weta is not the only one who has been having problems with her business.
Here come AliexsSky.
It looks like AliexsSky is as well, but this time it's not from a customer. It's actually from one of AliexsSky's employees from her Lux salon. Now, the employee is that she did not get paid in her last 2 weeks for work.
Come on, Mimi, I'm doing a review.
The main topic of the video. I'm not sure who else is posting it, but I will have the whole video on.
And I'm going to leave it in the video. I'm just playing. I might crop it. I'm just playing. I might not. And then she a capper, because she said great experience, but then she go on to talk shit, talking about, oh, that was the worst work experience. Was it a great work experience, or was it a worst work experience? Which one is it? Was it good to work there, or was it horrible? Why did you quit so fast? You ain't worked there that long. Cap.
Job I've ever had
So was it the great opportunity of working there, or was that the worst opportunity of working there? I mean, she still deserved her money, but it's like, which one is it?
Also have,
if you want to see the rest, YouTube it or Google it, because I ain't posting it on my page. That's just that,
you know, it posted on my Insta story where I found it. Now, of course, after AliexsSky seen this, she decided to respond onto her Insta story, and she said, "I don't want no one working for me ever again. Truthfully, I hire people to handle things for me because I have a million things going on in a gay man, and when stuff happens, obviously, it's going to fall on me. Yes, it's my business, but what is the point of paying people to run stuff? But I don't have time for this stuff. No more people want to clout and want to destroy people. All this app is good for. I'm taking a check out from everyone. Post whatever, tag whatever. Everything is closed." Then she also said that she's mentally drained because she posts and then says mentally she just can't do it anymore. And then she announces that the salon is closed. Like the lady already said on the TikTok, she said that it was closing. That was the last thing that she knew anyways. Then she also...
So it was closing down anyways. And so we see AliexsSky is capping too.
Story, AliexsSky posted to her Insta story a young lady who said that she's been working there for years and she always got paid. People are just clout chasing. And this kind of seems like it's probably someone who knows AliexsSky who's trying to stand up for her business or whatever. Or who's getting paid really good.
Years. How long she had this open for?
This young lady said on her TikTok was that she wasn't getting paid so good. So it's very contradicting stories that are coming out about these businesses.
Somebody's stealing money.
Even with the Jada Waita situation, some people love the merch. Then some people have bad reviews. Like, there's a lot of good reviews. There's a lot of bad reviews. And same thing with AliexsSky. But all I will have to say about these two situations, and even the AliexsSky situation specifically, when you're starting a business, make sure it's something that you really want to do. Because anytime anyone has a business, anyone with a business, they will tell you this, consistency is key. And along with consistency means when you're going through good, when you're going through bad, when your life is just hard, when it's great, when it's happy, when you're sad, when you're mad, everything, you have to go through every emotion with this business. You know what I'm saying? If you're not ready to do that, if you get easily overwhelmed with one complaint or this or a customer review, then you want to get out, you don't want to do it anymore, you close in the shop, you close in this, then you're not really passionate about it, sis. You know what I'm saying? Then maybe that business was
Everybody made bad decisions in that point, I feel like. Yeah, she just still talking. Yeah, that's all I'm gonna watch. So, yeah. If you don't want to do no business, don't get into business. Because that's what come with it. It's just a territory. She said she still work there to this day, but it's closed. Which one is it? I don't know. Too much shit going on. But I'm gonna do more reaction videos. Because I like doing this. This was cool. All right, y'all.